Hey guys and welcome. This is a quick tutorial about how we can make bullet holes when our projectile hits the environment. It's very straightforward and very easy to do, so let's jump right in and get started. Alright, first I'm gonna import the texture I want to use as the bullet holes into my content browser. It should be a PNG so it doesn't have any background, and if you couldn't find one, just download a JPEG, delete the background in Photoshop and export a PNG. Now I'm gonna create a material with it. Here change the material domain to Differ Decal and put the blend mode on translucent. Connect the alpha to the opacity so the mask works correctly. Now we have a decal material, and as you can see, by dragging it into the level, you can attach it to any surface you want. Now we just need to attach it to the objects in the environment whenever they are hit by the projectile. Here in the content browser, put the filter on blueprints to find the projectile and open it up. This is the code for the physics impulse system. As you probably have noticed, when we shoot projectiles to the objects with physics enabled, they make them move, and these are the nodes making this feature possible. If you want to keep them, you can connect the nodes we are gonna add to the false output of the branch and everything will be fine, but here, in order to make the blueprint look cleaner and easier to understand, I'm gonna delete them. Alright, now the first thing we need is a spawn decal attach function. This function will take care of the job, and all we need to do is to set these items correctly and we are good to go. In the decal material, choose the decal we made. In the decal size, let's go with 20. If it gets too big or too small, you can always come back and change the size to achieve what works best for your project. Connect the attach component to the other components in the event hit, and for the location, we are gonna use the hit location pin in the event. Next, drag a wire from the hit normal pin and add a rotation from X vector node and plug it into the rotation. The reason we are adding this is that we want the decal to have the correct angle on different surfaces in the level and not to pick a wrong direction and get messed up. This node will take care of that. Next, put the location type on keep world position and here add a lifespan. This means that after 10 seconds, the decal will be gone. Having a lot of decals in the level can be expensive on the hardware and drop the frame rate. So based on the complexity of the project, we should choose a lifespan for the decals we are using. For the last part, let's add destroy actor to make the bullet disappear after it hits the objects in the level. Hit compile, play the level, and as you can see, it's working perfectly. That's it for this tutorial, and if you found it helpful, please don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching, see you next time.